So again, we still are urging people in the community who may still be hesitant, you know, you're not going to get in trouble. All we want to know is, where is Kylie? Where is her vehicle? We just want to find Kylie.
The party was only supposed to be open to those in the Truckee Tahoe region, but word got out to Grass Valley, Reno, and the Bay Area.
It grew to be way, way larger than ever expected.
Within the only 10 minutes that I was there, I literally had a group of five guys try to come get me to take as many bong rips as I could, forcefully without my boyfriend present.
There was a lot of guys that did approach us. Definitely, I was getting a gut feeling during that party that something just didn't feel right with the amount of people that were there and how old some of these people were. From the amount of people who did show up, it was scary.
Authorities say that because they cannot locate her car, they're treating this as an abduction, and they are widening the search area along with asking parents of other kids at the party that night to go through their kids' phones, look at pictures and video and social media, and see if there's anything that will help authorities piece together a timeline.
This morning, this is a heavily wooded area. A large body of water is here at the campgrounds, and they're looking up and down throughout this area trying to find her.
Is anybody else out there? If you know where she is, if you know anything about where she might be, if you have any ideas or thoughts, please come forward and share them.
We believe out of the 200 to 300 juveniles and young adults who were at that party, somebody must know something.
All right, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so I had two cousins. They go to Sierra College, and that's in Roseville. Basically, like Rockland, Roseville area. And they're going up to that party. They heard about it. And they had some other friends going with them, but they're around like 27, 28 years old. They're older. And so there's a lot of older dudes there. And so I asked them if they knew her, and they said they saw her there. And that she was just like, you know, laughing, going from group to group talking. And they, you know, they didn't make nothing of it. But she was talking to, I guess, a bunch of people. Like, she was just walking around talking to everybody. And they said at the party, a lot of people were doing shrooms, cocaine, drinking, and all that. And I was like, yeah, but that's kind of normal, though. You know, a lot of, honestly, in Cali, in the area I'm at, everyone does cocaine. Like, all the younger kids at school, under 18, where, like, they all just buy cocaine from some old dude who lives in some apartment complex, and they buy coke, and they do it with their friends, and, you know, but that's kind of normal around here, so right. I wasn't really surprised about that. And so I asked them, I said, did you guys see anything weird going on? I was like, was anyone, like, looking at her friend? Like, nah, everyone was just chill, but everyone was kind of messed up, and so was she. And then I asked, I was like, well, how drunk was she? And they're like, well, she was like stumbling around. Like, you know, she wasn't walking around like, oh, yeah, I'm tipsy, I'm cool. She was pretty drunk.
Like, yeah. So stumbling around.
If she would have been driving around, she would have been swerving easily, like easily swerving. So there was no way she could have drove. And that's basically all I knew from that. And then they told me that there was some other stuff, but they can't really talk about it. But I knew from that. And then they told me that there was some other stuff, but they can't really talk about it. But that's basically all that they knew, is that, like, she was really drunk, and there was tons of drugs there. Like, not just drinking. People weren't just drinking. They were doing blow openly. Like, everyone was doing blow together. Like, going over to a group of people, you sit down, break a line, and it was like that. And it wasn't just a teen party. There was a lot of adults there.
They were saying it was like a high school thing, you know, so, but.
There was a lot of high school kids there, but there was a lot of mid-20s, like dudes who were still in college because they went to college later, you know, like, you know, probably been out of school for a minute, went back to, and then they heard about this party, but yeah, it wasn't just teens, there was dudes way older there.
Wow.
That's why I was kind of crazy that they were just saying it's a teen party. Okay, well, you had a bunch of dudes there that were way older than 16 years old. There's 26, 28, 29 year olds there.
Did they see her leave or no, they just saw her?
No, my buddies, we all came with the same group because I hang out with my cousins all the time. They're good dudes. Mm-hmm. But they went there to do I can't really say their names, obviously, but they went there to have a good time and do what was there. And that's what they do. But they didn't kick her with her like that, but they saw her. And they left, I think, around like 10:30, 11. So she stayed later than them. But they didn't say, like, they did tell me that they didn't see her wearing a sweatshirt at that time.
Did they see her in a tank top? Like the black spaghetti?
Yeah, she was wearing the bodysuit. Yeah, she was wearing the same outfit, but they didn't see her wearing no sweatshirt. So that's all I know, though.
And do you know if they, like, did they see anybody, like, creepy out there? Do people hook up out there, like, right there in the woods, too? Like do they?
Oh, like, I can't say the people. It's hard to explain. Like, there's So when kids go out there, because I've been out there, I've partied in Tahoe. I don't party as much anymore because I got three kids now. But I know when they go out there, a lot of kids go out there. They don't go out there with the drugs. They don't go out there with the shrooms. Like, they usually bring the alcohol. They get alcohol. The dudes who come out there, the older guys, they have the shrooms and the cocaine. And then the kids go hang out with that group, the older dudes, because they're giving them the blow and hooking them up with stuff that they can't afford because they don't really got the money for it. Because cocaine's pretty expensive.
Right.
And so you would go hang out with those group, do blow, then there'd be another group who has cocaine. And most of the guys, they always want to give it to the girls.
And it's being offered for free because they want the company and stuff.
Yeah, for free. They're giving you free lines. But then they want you to kick it with them. You know, oh, hey, come do a line with me. Come do a line with me. You know, that's how it goes. Those are how those parties are.
Right.
So there's no telling what could happen, but I do know for a fact she was messed up. That is a fact. So if they try to word it nicely, like, oh, yeah, she was a little, no, she was shit-faced.